and this one is even better than the last one. So, guys, here's the thing. There is absolutely no reason, there is absolutely no basis for, first of all, you or anyone to take this vaccine against your will. And there is no foundation, there is no mandate for anyone to enforce it on you. It is smoke and mirrors. We are being lied to, we're being played. Shocker, right? And who is facilitating this nonsense? Mainstream media. So I've been doing a lot of research to try and find the mandate from the government, whether it's public health, Ministry of Health, Ministry of Education, to find a specific policy, bylaw, law, guideline, directive about this vaccine mandate that they're pushing in schools, in the workplace, in the government, everywhere. And guess what? There isn't one. So the question I have is, first of all, even without all the notice of liabilities that you guys are submitting to protect your rights and to say no and stand up to this medical tyranny, even without all of that, there is no framework, there is no basis for these businesses, institutions, and government bodies to implement a vaccine policy or mandate. And who's going to support them? Who's liable in all of this? If the government didn't say you must do this and they're doing it, then doesn't that make them liable? And it also begs the question, is this also another attempt at destroying our economy by creating lawsuits, by preventing people from going to go out to bars and restaurants? Because don't be fooled. Do not be fooled by mainstream media. We are not the minority, the people that want our medical freedom, the people that want our freedoms. The people that took the vaccine, a majority of them, they took the vaccine and they thought, I'll just take this one shot and it's gonna all be over. They're not understanding that the vaccines will be never ending. Never ending, just like in Israel, just like in Australia, a booster every 6 months. Now Pfizer has a pill you take twice a day, all for a virus that is not even a risk for the average person. Sure, if you're over 80 or you have, if you're immunocompromised, however, even then you can treat it. There are treatment options available. We don't need a dirty vaccine that has not even been tested longer than a year. It's disgusting. So I'm gonna tell you where this vaccine mandate comes from. The only, and I also should state that if there's a piece of legislation that gets passed, if there's any type of law, legislation, directive, order, whatever, that it would be posted on a government website. There's various government websites for us to see. And that is by law. It has to be posted. It has to be public information. I can't find it anywhere. This is the only thing that I have found. And it is the newsroom from the government of Ontario. It says, Ontario makes COVID-19 vaccination policies mandatory for high-risk settings. It's the same story. Vaccine policies. There is no mandate, guys. None. And then it says this, and this is ridiculous. Toronto, in response to evolving data around the, are you ready for this word? Transmissibility, not the mortality rate, not cases. Now that it's that you can catch it. So, it's so ridiculous. So now there's a vaccine policy that's led to vaccine mandates because of transmissibility. What world are we living in? Okay, I will continue. So transmissibility of the Delta variant, and based on the recent experiences of other jurisdictions, so because somebody else somewhere may have had an outbreak, now we have to comply to make-believe orders because it could possibly happen here, maybe, but we don't know. The government. Which government? The government, guys. The government, in consultation with the Chief Medical Officer of Health. So let me read that again because I kind of split that up because it's so ridiculous. I wanted to break it down a little bit. It reads entirely, in response to evolving data around the transmissibility of the Delta variant, and based on the recent experiences of other jurisdictions, the government, in consultation with the Chief Medical Officer of Health, is taking action to increase protection for our most vulnerable, including frail seniors, you gotta put the word frail in there, immunocompromised individuals, and young children. Really? Young children are vulnerable? I think there's been 2 deaths of children under the age of 18, and they had comorbidities. So what are they talking about? They're not the most vulnerable. So basically anyone who's, and people who are not eligible for the vaccine. Okay. And it says that includes making vaccination policies. Okay. Policies. So the only other place that I can find anything about this vaccine mandate is mainstream media. But if you read what they're saying would, could, should, will, may. That is not a mandate. A mandate is you must. A mandate is you must follow this, and if you don't follow this, these are the repercussions. Well, so, guys, it's smoke and mirrors. It's smoke and mirrors. And all we have to do right now in this moment, don't even wait till tomorrow, is say no. I will not give you my personal and private information because that is in violation of my privacy. And there are, I think we've identified 10 privacy laws that protect you from sharing that information. You do not have to share it. Absolutely not. Now, with the vaccine mandate, are you kidding me? Are you kidding me? The government, whomever the government is, because they don't even identify who the government is. Is it the Ministry of Health? Is it the Ministry of Education? Is it the Ministry of who? The government. What does that mean? So now, it's the same thing with the masks, you guys. It's the exact same scenario, and we need to learn from what just happened, which is where they're allowing the businesses to make policies and then enforce them. Well, they're not going to get away with it, you guys. It is a criminal offense. A criminal offense. It's called attempted assault to coerce, to threaten, and to intimidate somebody into a medical procedure that they do not want. There is case law for this. We don't have to submit to any of this bullshit, nonsense, garbage, barf coming from the government. We do not have to submit our personal information. We do not have to do a test. That is a criminal offense. It's called Bill S-201. It is a criminal offense to use a genetic test to discriminate. We don't have to comply. Guys, stand up for your rights now. We have a whack of notice of liabilities on our site, standforthee.ca. People are already issuing them. They're getting responses. And guys, we have, the time is now. We can do this. We got to push back. We got to fight. We have to stand up. And there can be no excuses, because if you don't do it now, if we don't stop this now, it's going to continue just like this mask bullshit. Only it's going to hurt people. It's going to kill people. So we got to stand up, guys. Go to standforthee.ca. Go look at all the information that's on there. We have a whole Know Your Rights section. You can read up on all the legal provisions that we have to protect us. And don't think that we can't win this. And don't think that those legal protections are not valid and can't be enforced, because, oh, yes, they can. And if they could have implemented this on a federal level, they would have done it already. We would already be like Australia, because that's the goal. And there's a reason why they don't have an order, because they can't do it. They cannot. So let's finish this, guys. Standforthee.ca. Go get all the information that's on there. Get your notice of liability. Fill it out. Get your affidavit signed. Get it commissioned. Send it to the person that caused you harm. And let's start taking down the minions, because they're the ones doing the dirty work. And this is how we end this. Have a great Sunday. Now, how do I end this? Don't mind me, guys. I don't know how to end my life. Okay, now I'm going to end it. Thank you, guys. Love you all.